Hello students and friends, welcome to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 13. In today's session, we'll see the real HMI interface, human machine interface. We are in day 3. So here we'll be seeing about linking PLC program with HMI, human machine interface. This is something similar to the ATM machine. You will be using the screen, you know, so that is a human machine interface screen. So through that only you are communicating with the bank, you are communicating with the machine, and you will be depositing or withdrawing the money, something similar to that. These are the part lists that I used: a 14MR PLC, one push button assigned with X0, one proximity sensor assigned with X1. But actually these two are not necessary if you use a HMI unit. Okay, then 6 LEDs connected to Y0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Incidentally, the Y3 LED blown off. So physically it not work, logically it will work. Here I use a Samkoon, a Chinese brand, Chinese make 7-inch HMI unit now. Because the branded one is a bit costlier. If I use a original Mitsubishi or other Mitsubishi compatible HMI module, that will cost somewhere above 15,000 rupees or so. So this I could get it under 10,000 rupees. Okay. So then we need a special RS232 cable, one side male pin and other side is female pin. Through that only we can connect PLC with HMI. Okay, thereafter in addition to these X0 and X1, you can use the touch screen. So this is a touch screen actually. Okay, so this is in my view, this is the first and the important session as far as HMI touch screen is concerned. We'll see in action. First we will see the program. Let me open my previous day program, inline comparison program. I'll be saving it as day 13, PLC and HMI. Okay, so that time you had only X0 and this was not there. This was not there actually, sorry. This was the last time program. Okay, now here in addition to X0 we will be using another M. Through that M only the internal relay, through that internal relay only we will be connecting the HMI touch screen and the PLC. Okay, so let this be also be there, X0 also be there, and another internal auxiliary memory I will be using. So to faster the activity, so maybe let me speed up my work instead of a lengthy, it will take 15 seconds time, you know, I will cut short this to maybe 5 seconds. Okay, so 1 to 5.5 seconds LED 1 on. Then 225 from 25 to 30. Okay, so that is 0 to 0.5 seconds y0 on, 0.5 seconds to 1 second y1 on, 1 second to 1.5 second y2 on, 1.5 second to 2 seconds y3 on, 2 to 2.5 4 on 2.5 to 3 5 on. So instead of 15 seconds I want to complete everything in 3 seconds. Okay, let it be 31. So everything is all right. Now one more important thing here is I want to introduce another M. Maybe let me put this as 101. Let me put 101. Compile and let me fuse it in my PLC. Okay, so the PLC is on now. So let me online check it. Serial 8, serial 8 is COM 8 is connected. Let me fuse the program, main and command. So it is fused. Now in the meantime we'll see the components again, once again what I used now. Okay, so this is the HMI that I used, a Samkoon HMI. This is the programming, this is the serial port cable connecting the PLC and the HMI. For HMI program I use this USB cable. I think they call this as a USB host cable. You see this is the model that I used. It's a Samkoon. The label is hidden by a sticker, some sticker maybe, no problem. So it's a model number is a SA7A. Okay, so it is of DC 24 volt type. So this is the connectivity, the connection is, so now I have programmed, this is my PLC, 14 number PLC, push button, and somehow you could see the proximity sensor, the 6 LEDs are here. I put insulation tape to reduce the brightness. Then this is the HMI I used. Now initially the HMI, previously it had some program, okay. So no device response, meaning I didn't connect this one with the PLC, because you see PLC cable, this cable is not connected. I removed this and I inserted the cable for programming the fusing the program onto the PLC, right? So this is the model Samkoon SKR-SA07A. It's a 7-inch 7-inch type that I used. Okay, so this is on one side. So the program is fused now. Either if I input X0 or if I input M101, this program will be triggered. But X0 is a physical input, M0 is an imaginary input. This can be invoked through the HMI. Now we'll see the HMI programming. Here I used this is the software Samdra version 5.0 is the software for the Samkoon type HMI. Let me create a new file. The project name is my first project, you know, so 2020 program 1. Let me browse it in my HMI. Okay, then here I have to select 7A, SA7A, the resolution is 800 by 480, then horizontal. Okay, so yeah, everything is there. Go to next. Oh, program is already okay, let me type program 2. Next. Now this thing is also very important. Now you see this HMI is not only adapted to the Mitsubishi. You see these many PLCs we have: Mitsubishi, Omron, Siemens, Fuji, Delta, Allen Bradley, LG, Fatac, many. Okay, Hitachi, Samkoon itself, they are also making their own PLC. So these many PLCs we have, so we can use this HMI to any of this machine. So I am using a Mitsubishi compatible PLC, no? So I have to select Mitsubishi and FX CPE port. Next, screen 1. The background color, previously we used it had a yellow color background, right? Yellow color background. So this time I want a different background. So shall I use this one? A light rose color type of a background. Okay, so this is the background. Before seeing about the program control, let me add a text. This is simple thing only. My program on PLC with the HMI, my name. Let me have a bigger font. I can use different fonts also. Let it be system. Or Arial. Font color. Let it be a dark green. So my program on PLC with HMI by Dr.M.Sethil Kumar. So this is nothing, it's just a name. But we'll see the program now. This session I'll be telling about only one control. The control is nothing but if I press M01, this should run, right? So that alone we will see. Let me, this is the bit button. Okay, so it is off, it should be a momentary one. The right address is here, COM1 I have to select, M I have to select 101. So this one should match. This 101, you know, this one should match 101. Enter. It should have the monitor also. So same 101 I'll be typing, right? Then when it is off, maybe my background color may be red. Okay, when it is on, my background color may be green. When it is off, the switch is bigger, maybe 48. Let me see what happens. So bold italic 48. Yeah, it is put. Then for label in on also, let me put 48. A different color. Okay, so once again repeat, it is a momentary submerged. It will be sometime you may understand, you may not, I do not know, but I am doing it lively, right? So let me, so this M101, both should be correct. Then if it is on, you will see this display. If it is off, this display. So that is, if I press, if I touch that particular space, the M101 will be momentarily on, thereby it gets the signal here. After getting the signal here, this thing will run in PLC, right? So now this is the screen. It has only one button. Let me save. This is my program. Then I am also simultaneously taking a video. I have to pause the recording video, and I have to play the video that I shot while running, right? So compile and download, right? Now you see compile and download, you see this screen as well as that one, the program will be fused. So that is on. You see that the program is running here, it is there. So restarted, the color is changed. Once again, I will show you. Now I am compiling the program and downloading the screen and the PLC. Now the HMI program is being downloaded from here to there. Then downloading completed. Then you see the screen. Previously the screen color was yellow. Now you see the screen color. So you see that my program on PLC with HMI, Dr.M.Sethil Kumar, Industry 4.0 off. Now let us see this in action. I removed the programming cable. I am inserting the serial port cable connecting PLC and HMI. Now after inserting, this HMI is connected with PLC. Now let me touch my screen. It will go to silent mode after maybe 2 minutes of inactivity. Now it is on. Now I am just touching now that button. It is controlled through the HMI now. So now you see it works. Let me redo it once again. Yeah, touched. This is off. So this is how you can develop a program in PLC in coordination with the HMI. So you can do many sort of things. I think with this it is quite evident that you probably would have seen, you can see many videos YouTube, many videos in YouTube about the packaging machines, like masala packaging, biscuit packaging, many packages, liquid based product packaging, solid based product packaging. You can see the touch screens. The touch screen is nothing but the HMI. Okay, so now you understood the linking of PLC with HMI, the human machine interface. These are the part list, but I never used the, I gave the connection for X0 and X1, but I never used. I used only the HMI touch screen. Okay, hope you understood about how we can link the HMI test screen with the PLC, right? And we can write and control the programs, right? So subscribe my channel. If not, please subscribe my channel and inform this to other faculties and students that they'll also get some information about through my sessions. Okay, thank you so much.